Himachal News Bulletin. Here we'll get to this all the important updates of Himachal Pradesh in one go. So let's start. Moving to the first news of today's bulletin, those who become teachers due to fake degrees of Manav Bharati University will be on permanent leave. Teachers appointed in degree and Sanskrit colleges of the state will be discharged after taking fake degrees from Manav Bharati University of District Solan. Who are accused of fake degrees, the Directorate of Higher Education has summoned the records of those who become teachers in colleges on the basis of degree of Manav Bharati University. Director of Higher Education Dr. Amarjeet Kumar Sharma issued a letter to all the college principals on Tuesday, asking them to give information on email within 3 days. Moving on to the next news in today's bulletin, it rained for 29 days in August. Yet 44% less than normal. It rained for 29 days in August in Himachal Pradesh, but the state recorded 44% less rainfall than normal. During this period, 146 mm rain was recorded, while 262 mm of rain is considered normal during this period. This is the lowest rainfall in August since 2009. In August 2009, there was 52% of less rainfall than normal. During August last year, the state had rained 1% more than normal in August this year. It has rained for 13 days in the entire state during the monsoon session that has started in the state from June 13. So far, there has been 18% less rain. Only Mandi and Kullu districts have recorded above normal rainfall. Moving ahead to the next news in today's bulletin. NIFT will give life to 3 industries of Himachal. 2 MOUs signed. 3 industrial units of Himachal Pradesh are going to get Sanjeevani. The State Industries Department through NIFT Institute of Kangra is going to bring flying in the economy of these units. These include furniture units at Noorpur, Silk Mill, Bilaspur and Chamba Ghat in Solan. 2 memorandum of understanding has been signed between Director Industries Rakesh Prajapati and Director NIFT Akash Deganand in Kangra on Tuesday for the purpose of buying and liking their products of all 3 industries in the present market. After signing the MOU, Industries Director Rakesh Pudavati, while addressing the reporters, said that the experts of the NIFT Kangra will help to renovate these 3 units. This MOU has been signed in time-bound manner. Moving on to the next news in today's bulletin, which tells us about the corona situation in this state. 3 more infected died in Himachal. 202 people report positive. 3 more corona positive patients died in Himachal Pradesh on Tuesday. This tally includes a 89-year-old woman from Bilaspur district, a 64-year-old male from district Mandi, and a 21-year-old infected girl from district Shimla. On the other hand, 202 new cases have been reported in the state in last 24 hours. Till now in the state, 3,582 people have lost their life due to COVID-19. At the same time, so far, 213,548 cases of corona have come in the state till now. Of these, 208,305 have been cured. Corona active cases have come down to 1,642. Out of this, there are 366 cases in Mandi, 273 in Kangra, 154 in Chamba, 238 in Shimla, 218 in Hamirpur, 87 in Kullu, 108 in Bilaspur, 65 in Solan, 37 in Lahol Sipti, Kinnaur 28, 52 in Una and Sirmur 16. During the last 24 hours, 205 patients have been cured and samples of 9,586 people were taken for corona examination. Moving ahead to the next news in today's bulletin, the bugle of the election of Panchayat Raj institutions in tribal areas. Himachal Pradesh Election Commission on Tuesday issued notification for the election of Panchayat Raj institutions in the tribal areas of the state. Gram Panchayat, Panchayat Samiti, Zilla Parishad in Udaipur and Kirong Subdivision of Lahol Sipti and Zilla Parishad in Kaza and Panchayat Samiti elections will be held in Pangi Subdivision of District Chamba in Himachal Pradesh. As per the schedule issued by the Commission, the voting will be held in 2 phases. The first phase of polling will be held on September 29 from 7 a.m. to 3 p.m. whereas the second phase of polling will be held on October 1. A notification in this regard has been issued by the State Election Commissioner Anil Kumar Kachi. The model code of conduct has been implemented in the above areas till October 6. It is noteworthy that elections were held in Madhya Pradesh in 3 phases in January 2021. The term ended on June 24 in tribal areas, but election could not be held due to corona restrictions. Moving ahead to the next news in today's bulletin, which is related to the Directorate of Higher Education, Himachal. 18 school principals made deputy directors. Himachal Pradesh Directorate of Higher Education on Tuesday has appointed 18 principals of the school cadre as deputy director on placement basis. Pyar Singh has been posted as deputy director, education, Chamba district. Puran Singh has been sent on a deputation to the Directorate of Transportation. Shantilal has been posted as deputy director, elementary education. Kullu Gorakhnath has been posted as deputy director, section cadre, Shimla. Moving ahead in today's bulletin, after beat, now FCI will also buy paddy. After wheat, paddy will also be procured from farmers in Himachal Pradesh through Food Corporation India. State Agriculture Minister Virendra Tawar said in Basel of Afona that farmers should not face any kind of problem in selling wheat during the corona period. So the FCI procured 1.31 lakh quintals of wheat in the entire state and also gave good prices to the farmers. Now FCI will also buy paddy crop. He said that shallow tube wells will also be installed for the convenience of the farmers. Moving ahead to the next news in today's bulletin, START project will strengthen children's early education and infrastructure, Minister launched. Education Minister Gobind Singh Thakur on Tuesday organized a consultation workshop on National Education Policy 2020 in all districts and launched the STARS project from Dharamshala. He said that this STARS project is being run by the Government of India in 6 states of the country with the help of the World Bank. It consists of Himachal Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, Kerala, Odisha, Maharashtra and Rajasthan. Moving ahead to the next news in today's bulletin, 23rd Janmanch will be held on 12 September in all districts of Himachal. After about 6 months, the 23rd Janmanch program will be held on September 12th in all districts of Himachal Pradesh. Janmanch programs were postponed due to corona infection. Secretary Rural Development Department Sandeep Bhatnagar has issued a notification in this regard on Tuesday. Jal Shakti Minister Mahendra Singh Thakur will be present in Kullu's Ani. Urban Development Minister Suresh Bharadwaj, Shimla, Jubbal Kothari. Social Justice and Empowerment Minister Sarveen Chaudhary will be present in Mandi's Karsau. Technical Education Minister Ramlal Markanda will be present in Lahaul Sakti's Kaza. Moving ahead to the next news in today's bulletin, 6 players of Himachal will show their strength. A lot of money has been showered on players of the Himachal Pradesh in the auction of Pro Kabaddi League Season 8. This time, 6 players of the state will show their strength in Pro Kabaddi League. Arjun Awadi Ajay Thakur will be playing for Dhawan Delhi this time. He has been included in the team by the franchises for Rs. 46 lakhs. Apart from Ajay Thakur, Vishal Baldev Singh, Mahindra, Surendra Thakur and Rahul Rana will also play for different teams. In 3-day auction, all the franchises bid on the players of their choices. For the first time, 6 players of Himachal Pradesh have been selected. Teams bid well on Vishal and Baldev. Both were bought by Puneri Paltan for 60 lakhs. Surendra has been bought by Telugu Titans for Rs. 55 lakhs and Mahim Singh by Bengaluru Bulls for 50 lakhs. Moving ahead to the next news in today's bulletin, CM Jairam said PM Modi will address on vaccination on September 6th. Himachal Pradesh has achieved the target of immunizing 53.77 lakh 100% people aged 18 years and above as per 2011 census. For this, Prime Minister Narendra Modi has congratulated the state government. He had also given approval to address the people through virtual medium. PM Modi will also interact with some frontline workers of the state on September 6th, who have done incomparable work to achieve this goal. This was stated by Chief Minister Jairam Thakur while presiding over a meeting through video conferencing with Deputy Commissioners, Superintendent of Police and Health Officials of the state. From Shimla on Tuesday, he said that 90 LED screens would be installed at various places in the state so that people would be able to participate in this mega event. At the same time, Chief Secretary Ram Subhash Singh also asked the officials to start special programs to get the remaining persons vaccinated by September 4. Moving to the next news in today's bulletin, Himachal's Sneha Negi won gold medal in Dubai. Sneha Negi of Sangla Kinnaur, Himachal Pradesh has hit a punch on gold in the 66kg category at the Asian Youth and Junior Boxing Championship in Dubai. Sneha won the gold medal after defeating UAE's boxer in the final match. Sneha Devi has given credit for his victory to coach Shyamratan Negi, father Manoj Kumar Negi and mother Devi Negi. Moving ahead to the last news of today's bulletin, 2 arrested with Himalayan goat meat and Karu medicinal plants. Wildlife Conservation Department has arrested 2 poachers with rare Himalayan goat meat and medicinal plants at Palchak under Dholadhar Sanctuary area of Kangra district in Himachal Pradesh. The accused have been identified as Deshraj and Jovan, resident of village Nalota, Bada village district, Kamra. The accused had hunted two Himalayan Thar boats near Johori inside Dholadhar Wildlife Sanctuary. So that's it for today's bulletin, guys. We will meet you again tomorrow. Till then, take care, stay safe, bye-bye.